happiness. He was very happy, as I understand it. I was a breech baby, and people have said ever since then I've been arse upwards. But whether that's true or not, I don't know. It's not for me to judge. But the first few years were really, really happy times. Well fed, well cared for, lived with mum and dad and my sister. And then, of course, the war came along after 2 years. We had underground shelters, and they were deep down. And my sister and I were down there. And so at that point, my mother worked for an MP, a Scottish MP, and he invited us up to Scotland. And I loved it up there, absolutely loved it. When we came back down to London, I cried my eyes out when we were in Scotland. Because after the war, my father was demobbed, and he said to my sister and I, I'll take the handlers and you can have anything you like in the store, which was rather generous. I took a liking to a 9.5mm Pathé projector. Made quite a few films, mainly family, with 8mm. That would have been 1959, and they were having a house or flat warming party. And Ron said to me, would I like to go along and make the numbers up, because Margaret had nobody in the London area coming from Newcastle. And that was it. We met. And then Eileen said to Margaret, how did you like John? And she said, well, it's all right in small doses. And 57 years later, here we've been married, so quite big doses, really. Yeah, families are great. You go to bed one day with your first warm, and then you suddenly wake up in the morning, and there are two people there to care for, not just one, besides yourself, of course. And it's a strange realisation that you've got another life in your hands. When you get to my time of life, you look back and you look at your children, and then their children, and it's an ongoing thing. It's a perpetual thing, it just goes on and on and on. And in turn, that gives you a lot of sense, a lot of satisfaction. The strange thing is that when it was told to me, I was told that I had cancer of the blood. And that sounds more daunting than simply being told you've got leukemia. I can't stop it, it's inevitable. And I came out and I phoned my wife, was with me, so I told her immediately and explained that it wasn't desperate, but it was leukemia. Phoned my one daughter that was home, and she just burst into tears when I told her on the phone. And I tried to explain it wasn't desperate. I'm afraid when you hear the word leukemia, you think, give him 1 year at the most, and that's it. Well, here I am 15 years down the line. I didn't think backwards at all. Try not to. It's inevitable at times you will do it. A philosophy in life I have is never look back, always look forward. Because all the mistakes you've made in life, you can't go back and put them right. And even if you had a second life and went back again, the chances are you make all the silly same mistakes again. So there's no point pondering on something you can't put right. Otherwise, you simply go mad, I suppose.